Decorator candles are all the rage. Kathy's here with Vesta Abel from Commotion to share a terrific candle stamping technique to get the look at a fraction of the cost.
Thanks, Tiffany. Hello, Vesta. Welcome back.
Hi, Kathy.
More wonderful things.
Yes, I'm back again, and this time I'm going to show you how to do candle decorating that's really easy.
You call this candle stamping, and it is a wonderful technique. I love the look of this iris, and it's hard to believe that this could be a simple craft.
It is. You're not going to believe it. Have I ever let you down?
No, not yet. I'm having so much fun. You know, candles are really hot this year, no pun intended. And the decorator candles can be quite costly in the specialty stores. Mm-hmm. And this is what we're actually doing today, the sunflower candle. Right. And I can't wait to see how this is done.
Well, I'll show you step by step. And it's the stamping that makes it so fast and easy to do. Now, first thing you do, I'm going to use this black ink.
And this is this a special paper?
Yes, it's called Unriyu.
And it's a handmade paper that's...
It comes from the Philippines, and the main thing that makes it work so well for this technique is that it is very absorbent. So, I mean, you could use a paper towel, which is very absorbent too, but you're not going to have these beautiful streaks in it like this does. And see what you'll do?
Much better effect. So you stamp onto the paper, and this paper has great little metallic pieces pressed into it. There's a lot of neat handmade papers out there, and they are very absorbent.
Right.
To stamp right on the paper.
Exactly. And so, first thing you want to do is you want to take your paper. We have a big sheet in there for you to start with. And you're going to figure about how much you need for whatever candle you're using. You would just fold this around and kind of mark it over here. And then you'll cut your piece. And as you can see, we have a piece right here, and it will fit perfectly around here. And you want to do that because candles are not always straight up and down. They're tapered a little bit. So if you just cut a piece to fit on there, it may not. I mean, if you think it's going to work on there, it may not. So it needs to be fitted to the candle.
And do you have any overlap?
A slight bit, but you want it to fit perfectly because, it'll absorb into the candle better that way, which I'll show you. Then what you would do is you would stamp however many designs that you want on there, and then I'm just taking a Q-tip and coloring in.
Oh, that's great.
Isn't that a soft look?
Yes, and you just use the rubber stamp
and
the stamp pad, but a different technique.
Exactly. So after you've gotten all of it colored in, which you can see, it goes very fast this way too, and look how bright and vivid the colors are. Well, to save time here, I've got one that's already finished. We'll set these pieces aside. And then you always want to put down a paper towel to protect your work surface. So then I'm going to take this, and you want to start in the middle of your design like this. And the reason for that is it could get off course. If you start at one end, it could start to go that way.
Especially if it's a taper, like you said.
Exactly. So you want to use your heat tool. And what I'm doing here is I'm heating the candle and getting the wax soft. And when that happens, this paper is just going to absorb right into the candle.
This is amazing.
Yeah. Now, see how it's starting to do?
Yes, I can see the color change.
Okay. Well, what's happening is the wax is starting to melt there. And then what you'll do is you just keep doing that all the way around. See how that just absorbed into
it? That's great. Now, when I first looked at the finished piece, I thought that this was part of the candle, but this is actually the threads that are in the paper.
And it's laying on the surface.
Oh, it's wonderful.
But you can see what that does. And what you would do is just, you'd go all the way around this side, keep heating it and pressing it into it, and come back and do the other side until you have your finished piece.
This is terrific. Boy, people could do, if they had a theme for a party or a wedding or something, they could carry out that theme, make centerpieces. There are so many different papers out there and rubber stamps. And I know that our viewers are sometimes concerned about using rubber stamps for projects that they're going to sell. But Vesta has given our viewers permission to use any Commotion
absolutely.
Rubber stamps.
Make and sell whatever you want. You'll also notice with this candle over here that piece was cut out. And you can
This right. was actually cut out.
A little bit different method than this, but you do the same thing. You heat it and press it into the candle.
Well, Vesta, I know that we have a great Get Acquainted kit that has everything our viewers need to create this wonderful floral candle, and I thank you for sharing this technique.
Well, thank you.
Back to you, Tiffany.
Thanks, Kathy. If you'd like to write for free instructions, send a self-addressed stamped envelope to S422, Commotion Candle Stamping. And if you would like to order the Commotion Candle Stamping Get Acquainted Kit, number 122961 for $22.98 plus shipping and handling, just give us a call at 1-800-825-3363. Coming up next, Crazy Stitches from New Berlin. Stay tuned.
Fiskars three-piece cutting center offers the ultimate in rotary cutting. It's time-saving, accurate, and easy to use. Simply engage blade to cut layers of